Hello and welcome back to the Linux Panic YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to be going over what it is like to use Arch Linux install. But first, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos. So I'd like to apologize for this video being a tad bit late. I had another video lined up and it just kept chucking audio problems at me in DaVinci Resolve. And then we'll check in the video outside of DaVinci Resolve. It just kept dying on me even harder. So this is why this is not on time today. So we're going to be looking at Arch Linux install. So as you may or may not be already aware, pull that out of the way. Arch Linux Live USB has been coming with its own Arch installer thing for quite a while, but instead we're going to download a different one. So first thing we need to do is pacman-syou to let it synchronize the package databases. And yes, error occurred, no package updated. That's fine. And then we need to do pacman. I'll leave that for later. Me s arch install. Proceed with that. And now that's done, all we need to do is type arch install. And what? Because it's just going to do its things to prepare itself. And here we are. Would you look at that? A much easier and faster way to install Arch Linux. So it's got my language. It's got my keyboard layout. We're going to change the mirror region once it's caught itself up to the United States. I love how it has a rollback, which is good. So it's got the mirror region US, so it's going to grab everything from there. Bootloader, we're going to be using grub, which is what we want. We'll leave a swap in place. We're not going to change the host name. Root password, we're just going to leave as that. Yes, I want to use it. And yes, we'll use that one. Profile was and I guess we'll just go minimal. And then audio drivers, we will use Pulse Audio and no additional packages, network configuration, and we'll use network manager because it's just easier. Time zone, we're going to be set to United States, New York, America, you knocked. I had to think about that for a second because it's been a while since I've done that. Save configuration and then just, actually we need to go back. Actually, save all. And then we just need to check our disk because we didn't do that, which is a problem. So we've got to select drive, select that one. Disk layout, we will use wipe all drives and use best effort default partition layout. We'll use ext4. As we can see, it's just as easy as that. So once to install, hit enter, and it's going to begin like that. So it does everything for us, so we don't have to do it ourselves. Now, the ISO that I'm using was released on the 5th of this month, so it is the latest Arch ISO. Now, all this does, be prepared to sit for a minute or two and just have a quick sip of any drinks you have available. In my case, it is a root beer. It is a polar bear root beer made with cane sugar instead of corn syrup. In my opinion, it's made with proper sugar because I come from the UK and corn syrup is not really a thing in the UK. So the benefit to doing it like this is, as we saw, there is a save configuration option. So, for example, you could just save the configuration, put it on a USB stick, for example, and just plug it into a load of different computers saying install Arch like this, install Arch like this, install Arch like this, install Arch like this. So it's just
saves time and effort. And if I'm seeing that correctly, I could have just swore I saw a load of those 100s going at 103%. So yeah, the reason why video took so long is because I was having audio issues with another pre-video that I was prepared to upload. But as we can see here, this is just flying through. Now, my fastest install time for doing an Arch Linux ISO, Arch Linux install, is, oh, what was it, about 4 or 5 minutes after hitting enter from the install point. So this may vary depending on what your system specifications are. Mine is going to be using 4 cores and 8 gigs of my host CPU, or 8 gigs of my host RAM. 4 cores of my host CPU, which is a Ryzen 5 3600, non-X variation, and I have 32 gigs of 3000 megahertz RAM. As we can see here, it's just installing Network Manager, which is one of the final things to be installed. As we can see here, it is just finishing off with Pulse Audio, because as we saw, it was Network Manager, then Pulse Audio in the list, so it's actually doing it concurrently. Well, sequentially, there we go. I had to think about that one for a second. Then once we've finished with this, it just dump us straight to a desktop. And as we can see here, would you like to true into newly created installation perform post installation configuration? Nope. Now we just need to reboot. And would you look at that? We have an Arch Linux ISO installed in less than 6 minutes. I want to do Arch and then. I apparently don't remember the default Arch install login, so. So apparently I can't remember the. Oh, yes. Yeah, oh, I'm having a moment. It's root and then. Okay. There we go. I was having a moment clearly. So let's just do NeoFetch show. Pacman FS. NeoFetch. And then give NeoFetch a minute. Here we are. This took a grand total of 7 minutes 52 seconds, including my little dingus, little failure of the memory there. But here we are, we have an Arch Linux ISO install from start to finish in less than 10 minutes. Can you believe it? Anyway, I would like to thank you very much for watching. Check the links in the description for other things such as my Twitch, my Patreon, my GitHub. My GitHub is where you can also sponsor me there. It would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, I'd like to thank you very much for watching. I have been Nick, you have been amazing, and I hope you have a good rest of your day. Goodbye.